I was recently diagnosed with lung cancer and finished radiation about a month ago.
Meet Sophie. She's not an actual patient, she's a computer-generated avatar. But she could help doctors and nurses better treat patients, especially when it comes to talking about difficult topics.
When someone's facing the end of their life, I think the conversation starts off with just getting a feel for where they are, but I need to find a way to tell them this really terrible thing in a gentle and compassionate way.
What Sophie provides is a way to practice these skills without being in front of a patient.
Imagine doctors from any part of the world can go to a website, turn on their webcam, and practice the conversation skills with a virtual patient driven by artificial intelligence.
Not only can doctors interact with Sophie, but they can get a variety of metrics to measure what they did well and where they can improve.
The most important aspect of interacting with patient is listening. And how do you ensure that you're listening? By asking the right set of questions. And the quality of these questions will ensure that you're properly listening, as well as the turn that you're taking. And you can get all that feedback using this tool.
So we can see the speaking rate, how fast the doctors were talking. Then we have number of questions, so how many questions the doctors asked in the conversation, and then how many open-ended questions were asked. So the red indicates where the doctor's actually talking too long and didn't give Sophie an opportunity to ask questions.
So why use this tool rather than practicing with a real person?
Practicing with standardized patients or patient actors is a really valuable tool. We use it in our courses in the Advanced Communication Training Program, and it's really been wonderful. And there are challenges. We have to get all these human beings together at the same time. And so there is a lot of time and effort, and honestly even money that goes into it. And so having a tool like Sophie that you can use in small doses at your convenience, I think it will be a really valuable addition.
We analyzed 382 conversations between doctors and patients. So through that data set, we saw that when doctors are using a mix of positive and negative language, that actually helps the patients understand their prognosis.
The program is still a work in progress, but the goal is to make it as close to a real patient interaction as possible.
No matter how sophisticated the programming gets, it will always be a computer program, and so it won't have quite the depth of a human. But at the same time, it's a really nice place to start because it's very safe. You're not going to hurt anybody doing this. And it will allow people, I think, to sort of get their feet wet and start to practice those skills that they really need to talk to those real people.